Hey guys, how is it going? Sam here. Welcome back to another lab session. And again, this is gonna be on VPC. Based on the feedback, explain it with a simple VPC diagram. So this diagram, we have got this VPC and its CIDR block ranges 192.168.0.0/16. And then we have an internet gateway, and then it will take care of all the, you know, traffic to and from your VPC. We have a router which takes care of the routing table and things like that. We have EC2 instance placed inside the subnet, and the subnet ranges 192.168.1.0/24, and it is placed on an availability zone, and that's it guys. We'll try to implement it. But then once you implement it, what's gonna happen internally once you try to, you know, create this VPC? So it'll create a VPC with a /16 CIDR block range, and then it'll attach an internet gateway to the VPC. We will have to, you know, create a size /24 subnet with a range of, you know, 256 private IP addresses in the VPC. So let's you know, go ahead and do it. Navigate to networking and content delivery, and then click on VPC. And this time, for a change, we have never used this wizards, right? Wizard, Amazon provide this, you know, neat way with, you know, minimal complexity. You can deploy your end goal. In our case, it's gonna be the simple VPC. So why don't we use a VPC this time? And this will be the first time we are, you know, using the wizard in the lab session, right? So let's click on start VPC wizard. So here we have this four scenarios: VPC with a single public subnet, VPC with public and private subnet. We have an option for a VPC with public and private subnets and hardware VPN access. We have option for creating VPC with private subnet only and hardware VPN access. So in our case, as per the diagram, it is this, you know, single public subnet, right? So we are going to stick with the very first option. Click on select, and we'll be, you know, seeing this screen. The best thing about the wizard is it gives you this, you know, default value. So we are going ahead and changing it to suit our needs. It's gonna be 192.168.0.0/16. If you remember the architecture diagram, we are not gonna have IPv6 CIDR block range, so that's fine. VPC name, I'm gonna say custom VPC2. Next field is wherein you'll have to define the public subnets IPv4 range, CIDR range. So based on the diagram again, it's 192.168.1.0/24. And then the availability zone, I'm gonna say no preference. Let Amazon decide where to, you know, put it in. But again, you don't have, see, this is the whole point of, you know, using the wizard, right? You will have minimal inputs, and then you don't have to, you know, go through all the complexity. They will, you know, Amazon will take care of all the, you know, underlying provisioning. And then subnet name, let's say public 2 subnet, custom VPC 2, service endpoints, I'm not going to define anything. And then enable DNS hostname, you can. And then again, this is similar to the one which you have seen over there while creating the custom VPC for the first time. We have this multi-tenancy structure. If you wanted to, you know, go with that, or dedicated, you know, tenancy type, I'm gonna, you know, stick with default. Again, dedicated will ensure that there is a, you know, additional cost added to that. So just to, you know, save the cost and just to stay within the free tier, I'm gonna say default. I'm gonna click on create VPC. So you have this graphical view status. It's been, you know, shown over here, and then it says it has been successfully created. Let's click on OK. So the custom VPC2 is the newly created VPC. With the help of, you know, VPC creation wizard, we have achieved this. and then what are the items that got created? You know, this is quite different from the manual VPC creation, since we have used the help of wizard with the help of, you know, VPC creation wizard. Most of the things will be, you know, created automatically. That includes your, you know, internet gateway as well. So we'll, you know, take a look at it. Go to subnet and then take a look at this. Here we have this public subnet created. This is the name which we have given over there in the wizard itself. And then from the IPv CIDR block range, you can, you know, clearly understand that this belongs to our custom VPC 2, the newly created VPC. And then we have 251 address available, and since we have not provided any availability zone preference, Amazon has put it into AP South 1B. Route table created is this, and the NACL which is allocated with that is mentioned over here. And then auto assign public IP, it is set to no because we were not even, you know, selecting anything like that on the wizard. And then let's move on to the route table. So if we navigate towards the route table, you can clearly see that it has created two route tables. One is the main route table and then the custom route table. Main route table, this is the default one which gets created the moment you create a, you know, VPC. And then it has no route defined except this, and this is for the local traffic. The target is local and the entry point will be that. The destination will be this particular IP CIDR block. And then let's take a look at the custom route table. Here we have got two routes defined. The very first one is called as the local route. This will make sure that your instances within the VPC are able to communicate to each other. And then we have this destination. Every other IP address will be, you know, targeting or using the target as the internet gateway, and this will make the communication happen between the your internet and then the resources which are placed inside the VPC. And then the subnet is, you know, locked down to your subnet which we have created and defined during creation of the VPC with the help of your VPC creation wizard. Let's launch an EC2 instance into the newly created public subnet. Let's go back to the EC2 management console and then quickly set up or launch an EC2 instance. Again, Amazon AMI, Linux AMI will do it. I'm gonna click on launch instance. I'm gonna stick with a free tier eligible T2 micro instance. I'm gonna click on next. And here under network, I'm gonna select the new VPC, the custom VPC 2. And then a subnet, I'm gonna leave it as it is. And then we can clearly see that 251 IP addresses are available. And I'm gonna click on add storage. I'm not gonna do anything here. I'll add a tag over here, the name tag. I'm gonna call it as a demo. Click on configure security group. I'll create a new one. I'm gonna enable SSH. I'll enable HTTP traffic as well. Then I'm gonna click on review and launch. I'm gonna click on launch. I'm gonna use the existing key pair. I'll acknowledge that I'm reusing the existing key pair. I'll click on launch and let's take a look at the status. Now, as you can see, the demo instance is up and running. Let's take a look at it. So here we don't have any public DNS or IPv4 address. And then we have to access it anyway. And how do we do it? Let me explain it. And then on the theory session, we have clearly seen it. There is this concept of elastic IPs. So I'm gonna click on elastic IPs. You can click on allocate new address and then click on allocate, and you will be given a, you know, IP address based on the availability. And then all you need to do is, you know, click on actions associate address and then select your instance address here, and it will be done. Once you are done with using the instance and you wanted to, you know, release it, this is what you will be doing. I'm not gonna, you know, proceed with login to that particular instance. Anyway, it's gonna work out since we have, you know, placed it under public subnet and we have this internet gateway active. So let's, you know, wrap up the session. So this is how you will be using the wizard. All I wanted to say is that, and this is what we have implemented. We have created a VPC inside a region, and we have, you know, decided that let Amazon decide, or let Amazon take the call of you know, identifying the specific availability zone. We have not, you know, provided any sort of preference over availability zone. So that's that. And then the internet gateway, it got created along with the route table. We were seeing this two entries for the route table, one the main route table and then the custom route table. We have define the CIDR block ranges for the VPC and the subnet. We were successfully able to, you know, launch an EC2 instance into the subnet, and which will be accessible if you are, you know, trying it from the internet. But then it did not have the public address. So for that, what we have done is we have came over to this Elastic IP address. We have allocated a new address, and then in action, you can always, you know, associate that particular address to the EC2 instance. So let's, you know, do the cleanup. You can click on release address so that it will be, you know, pull back to the pool. Make sure that you are killing the EC2 instance as well. Let me kill that instance off. So demo, this is the instance. Let's terminate it. I'm going to click on yes, terminate, and confirm that. I'm going to go back to the VPC console. It's available in my recently visited consoles. So again, you can clearly see that we have three different VPCs. One, the default one, and then we have created my VPC in our last video session. And then custom VPC 2 is the one which we have created with the help of or by leveraging the VPC creation wizard. What you have to do is you can click on that. Go to actions, click on delete VPC. Make sure that you are checking this tick mark, and it says delete VPN connections when deleting the VPC. So just for the, you know, safety, guys, click on, you know, yes, delete. That's it, guys. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll see you in the next video.